Hello everyone, my name is Vijay Kumar and we are studying Power Engineering. In the last lecture, I covered the combustion equation or combustion reaction. In the last lecture, I have already told that there are constituents in the fuel like carbon, hydrogen, sulfur. These constituents react with oxygen. Accordingly, carbon forms CO2, hydrogen form H2O with oxygen. In the same way, so many reactions we have seen in the last lecture. Now in this lecture, we will study about the minimum amount of air required. Because you know that for combustion, what is required for combustion? Oxygen is required, time is required, temperature is required, turbulence should be there. All these are the basics which you have studied in your school time. So friends, in this lecture we will see how much oxygen is required for combustion of a fuel, or how much air is required for combustion of a fuel. Now in this lecture we will see the stoichiometric air or theoretical air or minimum mass of air required for complete combustion. How much air is required for complete combustion of fuel? For complete combustion of a fuel, we will study all these things in this lecture. Let's see. Theoretical or minimum mass of air required for complete combustion. The minimum amount of air that supplies sufficient oxygen for the complete combustion of all the carbon, hydrogen and any other element present in the fuel that may oxidize is called the theoretical air. For complete combustion of a fuel, the amount of air required, that amount of air is called the theoretical air or minimum air. Basically, this is the simple definition. I have already told that there is a constituents in the fuel like carbon, hydrogen, sulfur and any other element may be present. All these elements will oxidize in the presence of oxygen. Now, when complete combustion is achieved with the theoretical air, the product contains no oxygen. If there is a complete combustion will take place, then in the product, no oxygen will present. Okay. Now, consider 1 kg of fuel. We will study all these things for 1 kg of fuel. Let CKg, that is mass of carbon present in a fuel. H2 kg, that means mass of hydrogen present in the fuel. SKg, that means mass of sulfur present in the fuel. O2 kg, that is oxygen is present in the fuel. O2 kg means mass of oxygen present in the fuel. Basically, these are the constituents, carbon, hydrogen, sulfur, oxygen, that may be present in the fuel. And these values will be taken from the ultimate analysis of a fuel. This is not the part of your syllabus, ultimate analysis, and there is a what we called as proximate analysis. There are two types of analysis of a fuel, proximate analysis and ultimate analysis. From the ultimate analysis, we find the values of constituents present in the fuel. So all these values we will take up from the proximate analysis of a fuel. That is not the part of your syllabus. Now, for the combustion equation, for complete combustion of a fuel, total oxygen requires per kg of fuel. This is the equation. I'll tell you how this equation has come. You know very well that 1 kg of carbon, suppose carbon react with oxygen, then CO2 will form. So 1 kg of carbon requires 8/3 kg of oxygen. For complete combustion of carbon, of 1 kg carbon, How much oxygen is required? 8/3 kg. I have already covered this equation in the previous lecture. You may please see that lecture also. So 1 kg of carbon requires 8/3 kg of oxygen. So C kg of carbon, how much oxygen is required? 8/3 into C. In the same way, like 8/3 into C, in the same way I have written 8/3 into C plus 8H2 plus 1 sulfur. Here 1 kg of sulfur is required. How much oxygen? 1 O2, 1 kg of O2. So S kg of sulfur requires 1 S. This is the equation. And minus O2. Wow, how this has come? Because oxygen is already present in the fuel, so that amount of oxygen will be minus or will be subtracted from the amount of oxygen required in the fuel, because that amount of oxygen will also take part into the combustion. So friends, 8/3 into C plus 8H2 plus 1S minus O2, this is bracket and minus O2. This is the minimum amount of oxygen required per kg of fuel. This is the amount of oxygen, that is minimum amount of oxygen required for 1 kg of fuel. Now, how much oxygen is present in air by mass? We know that the air contains 23% of O2 by mass. We can say for 23% of O2, requirement of air will be 100%. And for mass of O2, which I have told in the last slide, this is the mass of O2 required. This is the minimum mass of O2 required for complete combustion of fuel. So for mass of O2, requirement of air will be 100/23 into MO2. So I'll put the MO2 value here. So theoretical amount or minimum amount of air required for complete combustion shall be M air per kg of fuel will be 100/23 into mass of oxygen required. This is the minimum mass of oxygen required, and that will be equal to 8/3 into C plus 8H2 plus 1S bracket close minus O2. So I'll put this value here. So this is the minimum amount or minimum mass of air required per kg of fuel. Friends, note that this is also called the stoichiometric air required for complete combustion. This is the stoichiometric air required for the complete combustion of fuel. Friends, in this lecture, we have seen the how much amount of air, that is the minimum amount of air required for complete combustion of a fuel. In the next lecture, we will see the air-fuel ratio, stoichiometric air-fuel ratio. Thanks for watching this video and have a good day. Bye-bye.